thread. Well, it was obvious on Saturday, Texas Tech did not let last week's loss to Oklahoma slow them down. The team had another chance to prove not only to a national audience, but themselves they could be contenders in the Big 12. KCBD sports reporter Blake Brody has more on Texas Tech's big-time upset victory.
After last week's loss to Oklahoma, the jury was out on Texas Tech's ability to hang with the big boys of the Big 12. But by the time the Red Raiders' 49-14 rampage of fifth-ranked West Virginia was over, the question became an emphatic answer.
Well, what a game. Who would have ever thought that that game would have been pretty much put away going into the fourth quarter? Really proud of our players, man. They worked hard all week. I thought the game plan on both sides, offense and defense, was great.
Really proud of how they bounced back. We preached playing hard and trusting the process, and I thought they played super hard. They thought it was big that we put this together. Offense, defense, special teams at home for our home crowd. I thought it was big today.
Total domination and a complete team effort. First, the offense piled up 676 yards, including 508 through the air, as Daigie quieted his critics and proved his status as a big-time quarterback.
You know, the rest of the guys, I mean, they stepped up. You know, we had a lot of opportunities to go downfield on these guys, and I think it was huge that we won on routes, did a really good job catching the football, and yards after the catch. So I think it was really good to see those guys perform at a high level.
For him to come back and play this well, especially in this kind of setting, you're playing number five team, the other guy across the way is the Heisman Trophy front runner, and to come out and what he threw for almost 500 yards, and man, he played. I can't say enough about the kid as a person, character-wise, leadership.
Next, the defense bounced back with a dominating effort, stymieing one of the best offenses in America and making Heisman hopeful Geno Smith's day one to forget.
Definitely had a big focus on him, and you know, all credit to the coaches to coming out with a really good game plan. You know, I think we schemed them up perfect and really locked down the run and then locked down their big receivers.
Even the lesser talked about players were big time contributors. Sophomore tight end Jace Amaro racked up 156 yards receiving with a touchdown, and SeDale Foster's 53 yard touchdown run right before half was truly a backbreaking run. Well, Texas Tech bounced back from its first adversity of the season in such a positive way, responding to their first loss of the season by beating the number five team in the country by 35 points. Remarkable. And in doing so, they showed a national TV audience that Texas Tech is here for the long haul and that they will be a factor in the Big 12 title race.
This is a truly a team, a city, a university win today, because not a lot of people gave us a chance. They looked at us like we got other. You know, they lost a game at home, lost to Oklahoma. Oklahoma's pretty good. They're going to beat a lot of people, but so are we. But again, that's just a total team win today.